And members one by one, and then we will go to discussion. This. So, the Sri Bhuvanesh Kalita to move that an address to be presented to the President in the foreign times. I think that is a seat allotted to him. Okay.
From the chamber, sir.
ये comments सबके लिए लागू होता है.
Honorable Chairman, sir. I rise to move the following motion. The members of the Rajya Sabha assembled in this session are deeply grateful to the President for the address which he has been pleased to deliver to both the Houses of Parliament assembled together on January 2021. Sir, the address which our President delivered on 29th of January 2021 is an important document and has historical significance. It is a speech full of achievements in different fields under dynamic leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji. The President, in his address, has
lobbies also to be created by persuasion, please, because it will be disturbing the members' attention. Please.
Thank you, sir. Please. The President in his address has outlined major policy achievements and objectives of the government during the course of my speech. I shall briefly refer very highlights of the address, sir. Our Prime Minister believes in the principle of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, and Sabka Vishwas. And I stand for the principle minimum government and maximum governance. It believes in empowerment, transparency, and is a firm believer of Team India concept. With the principle of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, more than 116 backward districts are identified for all-round development to come at par with the forward districts of the country. These districts are not selected in the BJP ruled states. These districts are selected which are backward and all over the country, even in the non-BJP ruled states. So, Sabka Saath, the concept of Sabka Saath and Sabka Vikas is reflected in identifying these districts, 116 districts for development. The government has taken care of all sections of the society. Poor, downtrodden, and underprivileged, and the people living in the rural areas. Priority of this government is Gao, Garib, and Kisan. The government is dedicated to strengthen the underprivileged sections of the society and build a strong nation so the life and livelihood is the priority of the government. Our Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, always believes in 100% and not less than that, unlike the previous governments. If it is toilets, it has to be 100%.
Shiva.
If it is houses, it has to be
Lord Shiva 100%. Cannot leave Himalaya unless there is something.
If it is electricity, it has to be 100%. If it is electrification of villages, it has to be 100%. But unlike other governments, this government under the leadership of Sri Narendra Modi ji aims at 100% and achieve 100%. Sir, I can mention here one thing in my state where projects were left undone or half done. I can remind you, sir, about the Bogibil Bridge. Decades passed and it was half done or undone. The Bhupen Hazarika Setu, was left undone or half done. So this government believes in 100% implementation of its promises and completed and made it operative, both Dr. Bhupen Hazarika Setu and the Bogibill Bridge. So this is the goal, this is the policy of this government. I'm proud that my state, Assam, has achieved 100% electrification in the villages. These projects were earlier left undone or half done or just started, but this government has completed it into 100%, sir. The president has highlighted how our country had to come together over the last year to overcome several adversities, including COVID-19 pandemic, floods, earthquakes, cyclones, locust attacks, and bird flu. The country witnessed an unparalleled, indomitable courage, endurance, and discipline of our countrymen. The most of the countries in the world appreciated us. The challenge was life, livelihood, safe life of the people of the country. Even the United Nations is appreciative of the actions taken by the government under Sri Narendra Modi ji and the steps taken to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic in this country and also help the neighboring countries. So, the country witnessed an unparalleled and indomitable courage to support the government and to support the steps taken by the government and come to a success, near success of tackling this pandemic. The most of the countries in the world which has been appreciative of this government under the leadership of Narendra Modi ji, also the organizations like World Health Organization, countries like Brazil are always and has been appreciative during this period. And our government, due to corrective measures taken from time to time in this period of corona pandemic, the economy has started recovering from the damage suffered by our economy and slowly emerging as an attractive place for the FDI as well as domestic investments. Sir, I rise to support the activities and the successes of the government led by Sri Narendra Modi ji, our Honorable Prime Minister. As per our economic survey, which has just been presented to both the Houses of Parliament by our Honorable Finance Minister, India's economy is firmly in the middle of a V-shaped recovery and will bounce back to record 11% growth in the 2021-22 after an estimated 7.7% contraction as per conservative estimates. It is because of our government's right decision under the leadership of our Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji that because of the 3 months lockdown since March 2020, it helped to break the chain and reduce the number of COVID cases in the country. Other nations are still fighting hard to contain the virus. Today, the number of COVID-19 cases is going down rapidly and the number of recoveries are also high. It is a matter of pride and great satisfaction for us that our country is running the biggest vaccination program in the world. Both the vaccines of this program, the Covaxin of Bharat Biotech and Covishield of Serum Institute, are under operation and the frontline workers are presently given, and that will follow step by step to others also. I salute our scientists, the medical professionals, and pharma sector for achieving this unique distinction. Lakhs of doses of vaccines are being provided to our other nations also, sir, including the neighboring countries, Nepal, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, the Seychelles, and Mauritius by this spring. India has already sent 3.2 million free doses of vaccine to Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, and Maldives. So, if we compare this with our vaccine with other countries, as you know, sir, and the whole world knows, that even countries like Brazil rejected the Chinese vaccine because of its efficacy. And even Brazil has opted for Indian vaccine, Covaxin. So, over a year of abrogation of Article 370 in Jammu and Kashmir, the people have supported government's policy of development. Only a few weeks ago, for the first time, Jila Parishad elections were held in Jammu and Kashmir and concluded successfully, sir. This is a significant achievement. The path of development in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh are open, and welfare schemes among the people are being implemented. So, the Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh has come to the mainstream of development where they were deprived earlier. So, after independence for the first time, for more than 300 block development council elections were held. RERA law is implemented. Jammu and Kashmir got reservation for poorer section of general caste, reservation for Pahari-speaking people, property rights for women, startup policy, trade and export policy, logistics policies are enforced. Terror funding has been stopped to the secessionists, anti-corruption bureau is set up, more than 24,000 houses under Prime Minister's Awas Yojana has been built after the governor's rule. 1.5 lakh shauchalaya are constructed, electricity is provided in 3,30,000 households, more than 3.3 lakhs are given benefits of Ayushman Bharat scheme. More than 1.5 lakh old age persons, women, Dibbangajan are covered under pension schemes. Elections for more than 4,400 sarpanch, 35,000 panchs were held peacefully. Our party, Bharatiya Janata Party, believe in unity, integrity and of the nation, and committed to Sarva Dharma Samabhava. Integration of the people of Jammu and Kashmir had been the wishes of the Indian people. Under Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, 80 crore people were provided with 5 kg food grains per month for 8 months. Government took care of the hardship faced by our migrant laborers, workers, and those who were away from homes. One nation, one ration card was provided, made food grains available, and also organized Shramik special trains for the migrant laborers. These affirmative steps saved lives from starvation during the lockdown and pandemic period. When we travel, sir, when we travel in the country, in my state, we find people that people were without jobs for some time. They were without food for some time. But because of this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, they could survive and they could live and they are prospering now. An amount of ₹31,000 crore was directly transferred to Jan Dhan accounts of poor women. More than 14 crore gas connections, gas cylinders were given free of cost throughout the country to poor women beneficiaries under the Ujwala scheme. Under the dynamic leadership of our Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, the country demonstrated its scientific capabilities, technical expertise, and strength of the startup ecosystem by developing a network of about 2,200 laboratories in a short span of time. Manufacturing ventilators, PPE kits, test kits, programs like Rashtriya Poshan Abhiyan, Fit India Movement, and Khelo India Abhiyan have helped in creating awareness amongst our countrymen, especially youths and children, and the importance of health was with this Abhiyan and Yojana, the importance of health is given most important priority. Under Pradhan Mantri Swastha Suraksha Yojana, government has sanctioned 22 new AIIMS. The decades-old Medical Council of India has been replaced with National Medical Commission. Sir, I may mention here that for 50 years in my state, in Assam, there were 4 medical colleges. But in 4 months of BJP rule in Assam, there are 12 medical colleges now. The members of Congress and some opposition parties are trying to block the proceeding last 2 days of this August House. Let me remind them that the 3 farm laws have been passed by both the Houses of Parliament and with much deliberations. The benefits of these 3 important farm reforms have started reaching to more than 10 crore people, small farmers. And in fact, there had been no reduction of rights and facilities of the farmers. So, rather, through these agricultural reforms, the government has given new rights to the farmers. Even after, opposition members are raising the issue to disrupt the house today. We have utmost respect for our farmers. Sir, the Agriculture Minister, Sri Tomar ji, and Honorable Minister Sri Piyush Goyal ji is having discussions with the farmers, farmer leaders. Many rounds of discussions are already taken place, and door is always open for further discussion so that this issue of farm laws can be resolved amicably. Government is ready to discuss all issues concerning it. But my appeal to our friends, please do not make it another Shaheen Bagh. What happened to Citizenship Amendment Bill? In the Lok Sabha, the bill was brought in. The opposition had objections. The government listened to it, and the government did not pursue it to be passed in the previous parliament. So, instead, it was given in the BJP manifesto of 2019 parliament elections. People of India supported BJP and returned to power with decisive majority, and CAA was passed. Now you have objections and you are objecting to it, and you want to organize another Shaheen Bagh. The NTCA leaders in Assam are now forming regional parties. 1, 2, 3 more parties are growing. And let me remind you what Congress got in 2019 Lok Sabha elections by supporting the CAA. The anti-CAA parties will lose in 2021 elections in Assam. BJP-led alliance will win and return to power with the blessings of the people of Assam. Under Pradhan Mantri Kishan Yojana, government is encouraging production of ethanol from sugarcane, maize and paddy. The annual ethanol production has increased from 38 crore to 190 crore liter. The production is expected to reach 320 crore liters this year, sir. Our government believes in Atmanirbhar Bharat. Rapid execution of major infrastructure projects and their completion even during COVID-19 pandemic situation speaks of volumes of government's resolve. Take the case of submarine optical fiber cable from Chennai to Port Blair, the Atal Tunnel or the Chardham Road projects. These are only some examples. There are many examples which I can give, because the Atmanirbhar Bharat, the principle of this country to make it self-reliant. If somebody has taken practical steps, real success has been shown by the government led by Sri Narendra Modi ji. The government talks about growth to boost the infrastructure of our country, to increase productivity of agriculture, industry, to create jobs for all sections of the society. Invest in road, railways, shipping, and also to see the coal and power sectors play a pivotal role in the country's economy. The Vande Bharat mission of this government has been hailed universally. Our country has registered a record improvement in the ease of doing business, ranking India has moved from 65 to 34 in world tourism ranking. Sir, it is a matter of pride for all of us that India has joined the Security Council as a non-permanent member in the United Nations for the 8th time by getting support from countries of nations who are close to India. This reflects our growing relations with other countries. Now, let us see the flagship successes of this government. Sir, the Ayushman Bharat, which is unique in the world, has seen grand success during this period. The health insurance scheme launched in September 23, 2018, has already benefited more than 10 lakh poor patients. More than 500 million Indians who could not afford medical treatment for non-communicable illness like the cancer, the heart disease, now have access to free health care. So the insolvency and bankruptcy code, which has made ease of doing business and more easier, was pending for about 40 years. And the previous governments did not take any step to bring the insolvency and bankruptcy code. The legislation enacted in the silver bullet to tackle Indian chronic problem of non-performing assets, banks have begun to recover debts that had seemingly turned irretrievably bad. So rural electrification is one of the flagship program of this government, which has seen utmost success in the recent past. The government's push to provide last mile connectivity to access rural clusters has been appreciated by this country. And I can say that in my state, every village has got electrification. Every village has got electricity now. The free LPG cylinders under Ujjwala Yojana schemes, women in villages now have access to cooking gas. We know, so how our women, how our women folk were suffering because of this. Now, this has both health and economic benefits. Health benefits for the women and economic benefits for the others. Over 60 million free LPG connections have been given, with nearly 50% going to the SC and ST households. Sir, the implementation of the goods and services tax was a bold step on the part of this government. This was pending for 20 years. GST collection are picking up as the economy is on the path of recovery after the COVID-19 pandemic, sir. Keeping in mind the welfare of all sections of the society, the governments under the leadership of our Prime Minister have created opportunities and inclusion of peaceful environment to bring permanent peace in the northeastern region. Sir, the Assam government during last 4.5 years achieved notable successes in realizing the above goals of making the state free from illegal migration, insurgency, corruption, and pollution. These were the above goals of the government, and the Assam government has achieved this. So the government public relationships and transparency is the hallmark of the Assam government today. The Jati, Mati, and Bheti secured for the indigenous people. Our Honorable Prime Minister visited Assam recently. He himself distributed Myadi Patta for 1,06,000 people by his own hand. Sir, this will secure the land rights of the landless people in Assam, and particularly the indigenous people of Assam. Under the guidance and efforts of dynamic leadership of Sri Narendra Modi ji, BTR Accord was signed in January 2020, bringing an end to the Boroland movement. Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji addressed the biggest ever rally in Boroland, bringing the boroughs and non-boroughs together. Honorable Home Minister Amit Shah ji addressed the completion of 1 year of the accord recently. Sir, the Boroland was divided between boroughs and non-boroughs. Recently, the elections were held to the Boroland Territorial Council, and all boroughs and non-boroughs participated in the election, came to one platform and elected a territorial council recently in Assam. Nearly 30 years long movement of the boroughs took toll of 4,000 persons in violence. Boroland Territorial Council elections has shown the path to the other parts of the northeastern region to strengthen the democracy in that part of the region. Another record for resettlement of Bru tribes has brought solution in states of Mizoram and Tripura, where we have seen disputes and clashes because of this problem. Recently, it has been settled, and resettlement of Bru tribes has been completed. Besides bringing peace and tranquility in that region, the insurgency has gone down, terrorism has gone down, violence has gone down, sir. But besides bringing peace, the second most focus of this government is development and connectivity. The government had supported ushering in progress in under Act East policy. The work of connecting Myanmar and other neighboring countries with northeastern region, the road and rail connectivity is under progress. Air connectivity is being expanded to the neighboring countries under Uran connectivity of this government. In Assam, national highway work of around 19,000 crore are currently under progress. I am happy that another rupees 34,000 crore covering more than 1,300 kilometers will be undertaken with the allocation in the budget of 2021. I thank this government. Tea industry is the dominant industry in Assam. We have to give more and more attention to these industries because this is the only industry surviving successfully in the northeastern region besides other industries. The budget of 2021-22 allocation of rupees 1,000 crore for the welfare of tea workers will benefit the tea workers of Assam. And I appreciate the feelings that this government has shown to the northeastern region, which has been backward till recently. But let me tell you, sir, our Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, after coming to power in the center, has visited Assam 40 times. I think no Prime Minister in previous governments visited so many times to look after the people of northeastern region, sir. Sir, his recent visit to distribute pattas to the indigenous people was a successful program, and he was welcomed by more than 5 lakh people in a rally, sir. So I want to raise some of the issues of the tea industry in Assam. The tea industry, which is one of the premier industry in the country, and Assam produce major tea. Assam is a major tea production state, and we have to give attention to this industry. And I am really glad that the tea workers are given importance. Tea workers today are, by the state government, by the central government, are given priority, and they are getting their due, they are getting their houses, they are getting their schools, they are getting their health care, and the community as well as other communities are prospering during the rule of Sri Narendra Modi ji. With this, I support the President's address and do hope that the whole House would support the President's address and would adopt the motion unanimously. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Bhuvanesh ji. Sri Vijay Pal Singh.